From across the Rio Grande Valley, taking action for you. This is Action 4 News at 6.
Action 4 News.
Thanks, Romeo. Now, during the trial, jurors were not allowed to hear testimony from the actual accident because Maples and Global Limo do not face charges related to the blaze.
Yeah, the victims and the relatives of victims have already reached an $11 million settlement with both Global and Bus Bank. That's the travel company that hired the other company. And a former high-ranking San Benito city official sentenced to time behind bars is preparing to walk free tonight. And that is not sitting well with the community. Let's go to Action 4 News reporter Marcy Martinez. She joins us now live right here in the studio with the details. Marcy.
Well, Michael, and now to an Action 4 News follow-up. Calls and emails have been flooding our Action 4 Listens line concerning two pit bulls who are accused of killing one woman's chihuahua.
Well, tonight, the owner of the pit bulls is speaking out. Action 4 News reporter Elizabeth Garcia joins us now with more on this story.
Action 4 News.
All right, there you go. Mrs. Alvarez says she will keep pressing on. She tells Action 4 News that she has a court date scheduled for the 17th of that month, and on that day she'll present her issues and her petition to Mission City Council.
And Mike, this story, like so many others, came to us straight from our Action 4 Listens line. You speak and we listen, Valley. All you have to do is contact our Action 4 Listens line. That number right there on your screen, 1-877-457-7867, or email us at listens@kgbt4.com.
Some Winter Texans are vowing to fight Hidalgo County over taxes. Today, in a crowded meeting, they called the taxes on the RVs illegal and unconstitutional. Action 4 News reporter Ray Pedraza explains tonight. The Hidalgo County Tax Appraisal District says that deadline for filing a protest is May 31st. The hearings will actually begin in mid-June, and at that time, the board will decide to add or remove them from the tax rolls. In the meantime, though, the group of protesters is eyeing a class action lawsuit set for a hearing in Cameron County. That'll happen on January 29th.
And again, this is another story that came to us straight from our listens line.
We get a lot of calls, a lot of emails, and we love each and every one of them.
We do.
All right. We also love Larry James. I can say that, can I?
And we love the weather and the video he's about to show us.
Well, let's look ahead right now. Coming up, he's danced his way to the top with the stars. Now he's coming right here to the Valley. A first ever event is now planned with a football great, helping raise money to send Valley kids to some of the top colleges and universities.
But first, we have new information tonight on some complaints filed against ex-Cameron County Judge Gilberto Hinojosa. But do they have any merit? We'll tell you when we come back.
Taking action for you. This is Action 4 News at 6.
Well, we're also following another breaking story out of Orlando. A man was shot this morning at the Expressway Mart off of Orange Blossom Trail. The shooting actually happened at about 5:30, the victim has been transported to ORMC. No word yet on his condition. The gunman, though, is still on the loose. We have a crew on the way. We'll have the latest in a live report for you coming up later in the newscast. And finally, good morning. Thank you very much for tuning in. As you can tell, it is a very, very busy day out there, and we're glad you decided to spend your time with us right here at Fox 35. I'm Michael Brooks. We're going to have more on all those stories coming up in just a minute, but first we're going to get you off to a good start today. Here's a holiday forecast. Compliments of meteorologist Doug Kammerer. Hey, Doug.
Hey, Mike. And that
buckle up and drive safely. Back to you.
That we will, Jessica. Thank you very much. Hey, new this morning, Volusia County Sheriff's deputies are investigating what they are now calling a suspicious death. A body was found in some woods near I-95 and US 1, just north of Ormond Beach. Investigators have not determined the sex of the victim or how long that body has actually been there. If you have any information, call the Volusia County Sheriff's Office. The city of Cocoa has a new interim police chief today. Assistant City Manager Clarence Holsey was appointed to the position on Monday, but the interim police chief is also under fire because Holsey recently faced scrutiny for emailing a racially and sexually offensive joke to a police officer who was a friend of his and who then circulated it on to other city employees. Former Chief David Crawford resigned on Friday but gave no reason for his abrupt move. A nationwide search is underway to hire a new permanent police.